Hello everyone, I'm back with another video. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can download and install CodeBlock IDE for C programming. So CodeBlock is a very popular IDE used to develop C and C++ programs. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can download and install CodeBlock IDE. For that, just open your favorite browser and search for CodeBlock and open the first link. So this CodeBlock is a popular IDE for C and C++. So we are going to download CodeBlock. For that, just click on download and here you get different options to download. One is binary release and here we have another option, the source code. We are just going to download binary release. Just click here and here you have to select your operating system. So my operating system is Windows, so I'm going to click here. So now here we have different version of CodeBlock. So this first one, setup.exe, is an IDE. It will not come with C compiler. To install IDE and your C compiler, we have to download this one, minjw-setup.exe file. So this minjw is a compiler. So we need to download this one. To download this one, just click here. And it will redirect you to download page. So it's going to download. So as you can see here, CodeBlock is downloading. So it is around 86 MB. It will take few minutes to download. So a file has been downloaded. Let's open the file. Just click on yes. So here we get CodeBlock setup wizard. So let me minimize my browser. And here I'm just going to click on next. So here we have license agreement. Just click on accept. Don't change any setting. Just keep it default and click on next. And then click on install. So it's going to install CodeBlock on your system. So here we get pop-up. It says, do you want to run CodeBlock now? Just click on no. And then click on next. So we had successfully installed CodeBlock. Just click on finish. So by downloading CodeBlock winjw-setup.exe file, we can install both the IDE and the compiler. So now let me open CodeBlock. So here you can find that CodeBlock is an open source and cross-platform IDE. So here you can see that compiler has been automatically detected. So the compiler name is GNU-GCC compiler. Just click on OK. And here just select the first option, then click on OK. So this way you can install CodeBlock with compiler. So now let me show you how you can create your first C program using CodeBlock IDE. So this is our welcome screen when we open our CodeBlock. So here we can create new project and we can open our existing project. So right now we don't have any project. So we are going to create a new project. To create a new project, you can click here or you can click on file. Then you can click on new. Then here you can select project. So now here we have to select our template. Just click on console application. Then click on go. And then click on next. And here we have to select our programming language. So we had installed CodeBlock with a compiler. So this compiler can compile C programming language and C++ language. So now you may ask me, what is this compiler? Compiler is nothing, but it is a piece of software which convert our high level language to low level language. That means it will convert your programming language to machine language. So here let us select C because we are discussing about C programming language. Then click on next and here give your project title. Say for example, my first C, and here you have to select your location where you want to save your file. So right now I want to save it on my C programming folder. Then click on OK and then click on next. So it will automatically detect your compiler. So our compiler name is GNU-GCC compiler. So this compiler can compile both C programming language and C++ language. So I had already told you that compiler is a piece of software which convert our programming language to machine language. And don't change these settings, just keep it default and click on finish. So on left hand side here you can see project view. So here we have all the folders we had created. So we had just created a new project called my first C. So here we have source folder. So let us open this source folder. So when we open the source folder, here we get main.c file. So let us double click this file. So here we have a simple program which will print hello world on our console. To run your program, you can click on build and you can click on build and run. Or you can just click this icon. So let me click on this. So see here on our console, here we get hello world. So let me close this. I hope you got an idea how you can create your very first C programming project.
So if you don't know about C programming and you want to learn C programming language, then check my playlist on C programming. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Bye for now. See you next video.